Hello and welcome to this week's commodity update. My name is Ola Hansen. I'm a senior manager here at Saxo Bank in Copenhagen. Looking at commodities this week, there's only one theme really, and that's oil. Everyone's eye is on oil because it's now really having an impact on all other asset classes in general. So much now that if you look at the US stock markets, we are starting to see that turning negative for the first time since November 2010. So the wider economy is really suffering now. And so what's really causing this? I mean, when we look at the headlines, it's fairly easy to see that we have the surging oil prices on the back of Libya, which is where the situation now is. I mean, it could turn into a civil war. We have street protesters in Yemen, Oman, and Iran, and obviously Iran is the second largest exporter in OPEC. So if this spreads, it obviously would have an impact, and that impact is being felt in Saudi Arabia already now, with the stock market there is down 14% over the past week. So and that's the biggest drop we had since 2008. So there really is this worry still that there will be some contagion and a rollover effect to the global economy as a whole. Yeah. Manufacturing data actually continues to improve and has been looking good. The GDP numbers at this moment in time is only being reduced to a small extent for the first quarter, but there's no doubt if we're going to have these oil prices, elevated oil prices, stay with us for longer, it will have an impact. But let's just look at the commodity markets this week, because in generally they are all up, but for various reasons. So if we turn to the screen here, again, we have most of the markets in plus this week. We only have a few in minus down here. Hawks and natural gas is at the bottom. And generally, the commodity index, CRB index, is up 3%. And up in front, we can almost say the usual suspects, which are cotton and sugar. They're both recovering strongly this week after recent setbacks. We have something like corn, which is really out in front. We saw a big sell-off in the grain markets last week, and that has now started to recover. And those that are recovering the strongest is where we have the biggest supply shortages coming into 2011. And interestingly enough, we have gasoline down here as well, and these two kind of go a little bit in hand, because obviously higher gasoline prices means ethanol production becomes more profitable. And actually, if we just look at if we stay with gasoline, we go over here on this chart, we can see how this is back to 2008. We can see the average gasoline price for US consumers, and the average price for 2010 was down here, and we since the beginning of the year, the gas price in the US has risen by 22%. So the motorist over there is really starting to feel an impact now. And we're actually trading above the average for 2008, where we had this big rise and subsequent supply drop. So it's getting into semi-critical levels now for the US motorist. And obviously, there's a large percentage of US energy consumption going towards gasoline. So, but high gasoline prices, high ethanol prices, and thereby also higher corn prices. So that's one of the impacts we're seeing there. Elsewhere, we have the safe havens, as we got silver, which is up nearly 4%, and gold is only a small change in the week, but in fact we managed to make a new record high yesterday, but we'll come back to that. Let's just stay with the oil for now, and if we move to this, if you just look at this, we've shown this before, but these are different oil varieties, and the two really we keep an eye on is the WTI crude, which is this morning trading above $100 again. It had the highest close yesterday for 30 months, and Brent crude, which is trading some $15 higher. We had a very dramatic spike higher, nearly reaching $20 last week, and since then we come back a bit, but we're trading kind of in the middle of a 110 to 120 trading range for Brent as we speak. And this is obviously to do with the worries about supply shocks coming from especially Libya, but also if it should spread to the Middle East. We can say that so far it looks like Libya has, out of the 1.6 million barrels a day they're exporting, something like a million is locked away in Libya, basically can't reach the global market. It's having an impact on the tankers, which is shipping oil across the Mediterranean, because the rates for hiring tankers in the area has risen by 600% over the last week, basically because a lot of tankers now are stuck or lying idle in Libya because they're waiting for the supplies which they can't get. So it's had a very big impact on tanker rates around the Med. And if we just leave oil for now and then just move to gold, because as I said, we Yesterday we managed to finally to break the records we made back in November. It's been really since the sell-off we had in January. We've seen this slow recovery, and actually just scattered some pace yesterday. We're now trading 14.33. One of the reasons why something like silver has outperformed so much stronger than gold over the past month is to do with the amount of money invested into these products. Gold is holding more than 50% of all the investments into commodities in general, and with this risk adversity we saw during January and into February, gold has been on the receiving end of investors having to remove some liquidity from the market. So gold, even though fundamentally and it looks it's still pointing higher, it has been suffering a little bit on the back of that recently. But yesterday it really broke higher, and really with the unrest in with the oil-related unrest and the subsequent impact on inflation, gold and silver looks continue to shine for the foreseeable future here. Okay, as mentioned before, we've seen a 5% rally in corn over the week, and if we look at the chart here, we can see this dramatic sell-off we saw in just a matter of a couple of days last week, and we have almost managed to regain the whole of the sell-off. And it's to do with a couple of things. As we mentioned earlier, the gasoline prices are going up. That's supporting ethanol price, which again is making corn at these levels relatively cheap compared to gasoline. So that's having an impact. But also the general outlook for corn production and corn stocks as we move into 2000 level is the lowest of all the grain varieties we have. So that's why corn is being supported, and it's outperformed wheat by 4% this week. Something worth keeping an eye on there. Also, on the good news, we can say that the rice has actually remained steady after the recent sell-off. We're now some 17% below the highs we saw just a couple of weeks back. And it's worth keeping in mind that the prices currently are much, much lower than what we saw back in 2008. So from a food security point of view, as long as we see rice stay at these levels, it's obviously good news for those who use rice as a stable diet. On a final note, let's just return to the oil prices and the rally we've seen over the last couple of weeks here. It's really important to keep in mind that the big oil rally we saw back in 2008 by many economists is actually used as an explanation for the recession we had in 2009, even more than probably the financial crisis during 2008. So the fear of spiking oil prices here is very relevant, and that's really what is currently keeping the market very nervous. Also, the problem is before this oil crisis kicked off, the main focus was actually on central banks and when they were starting to raise interest rates, because we've seen inflation going up across the globe. But if we see another energy shock here and subsequent risk of the economy going into reverse, obviously they won't be able to do anything on interest rate for the foreseeable future, and that's obviously lending a hand to those who fear inflation, and again they would be looking for hedges against inflation, and that's where precious metals comes in. So that's one of the reasons why precious metals have been very strong recently as well. So that's it for now. If you can read more on TradingFloor.com if you want to read some more of my comments or some of my colleagues, and I will see you next time. Thank you.